Welcome to lesson two. I hope you had a bit of fun with lesson one. Lesson two will be looking at some scenarios where we all will learn how to score the different collections from the different universities that are participating in this pilot run. In lesson one, we did two things. We described the rating scales, and then we looked at the layout of the OER platform for a typical university. In this lesson, we are hoping to do just one thing. We're hoping to score the OER repository of a university using the eight collections that we have. Talking about the eight collections, these are the eight collections of conference papers, corporate books, lecture notes, journal articles, videos, and all of that. The overall goal, dear participant, is that at the end of the training, just like we have for accreditation, we're happy that Professor Biodun Saliu has joined us, who is Director of Quality Assurance of National Universities Commission. What NUC does is we bring the accreditors together, all these professors, and then walk them through scenario by scenario how they will score. So that at the end of the training exercise, each accreditor will score almost like the same thing as another. So reducing what we call inter-rater variability, or narrowing or enhancing inter-rater reliability. So that is what we are hoping to do. So the instruments for the scoring, you are already aware. I emailed this to all the participants a little while ago. It looks like this. Already emailed, as I said. It looks like this, where you have the name of the university. You have the link. As I noted here, this link will change. This is the original link of the original collections that the universities have. I've asked them not to change it. They should keep them. And then for the purpose of ranking, they will then aggregate all these collections on the different types, the eight types that we mentioned before. So this is how the instrument looks like, which I've emailed to you. So how do we proceed with the scoring? In this scenario, we have a three-step process in scoring. The first thing you do, you want to assess a university. You have to go to the university. You have to go to the site, just like accreditation. Accreditation, as I said, you go to that university. So now we're going to go virtually to the university, to the site, the OER site that the university has supplied. The next thing is to now go, it's just like department by department. You go to the different collections one by one, and then you look at the links, and then you just count the number of active links active links to full texts. And then the third thing you do is just to score based on the guidelines that we have given earlier, and then enter the score in the appropriate column. It's as easy as that, but let's do it in practice. So step one is that you go to the OER site of the university. So let's go to one of them. So let's take actually the first one. That's Abia State University. So I've clicked on it, and that's what we expect that you should do. I'm now going into Abia State University, Uturu. So it's loading here, home, Abia State University, the OER collection. So where are you? Okay, fine. So this is it. But you see, this is not what we'll expect that Abia State University should present to us. This is the original thing that they have. As I mentioned in an earlier video, is not collect. Okay, let's see. You have journals. Oh, that's nice. Journals, inaugural lecture, public lecture. Oh, Abia State. Oh, well done. Let's look at the inaugural lecture. Let's see whether anything is there. Nothing. So as you can see from this URL, there's nothing that is connected in there yet. But we expect that Abia State University, if it's going to participate in this ranking, should give to us something like this. Yeah, what we can call ranking compliant OER site. As we mentioned to the ICT directors in the universities, they should keep what they have, like Covenant University, Ahmadu Bello University, all of it. Just keep what you have, but have a ranking compliant site like this, which will have all our three collections, excuse me, eight collections. So this is coming now to the site. That's step one. Step one is done. Step one is you come to the OER site of the university. So let's go on to step two. So step two is for us to click on the collections. How many collections? 8 of them. We click on them one by one. And when we click on one, we go through the links. And then we count the number of active links to full text. The links that are active to full text. So let's do that practically. So let's begin from here. This one collection, the books. So we ask that you click this. I've clicked it. It's rolling. And we are to count the number of active links one by one. So this is the page showing the books for this university. Let's assume that it's Abia State University. And then we have all the books that the professors or all the, any staff of the university have put together. And as you will notice that I have put some in red. The ones that I put in red by way of a hypothetical presentation here are those. Please note, the list below is for demonstration purposes only. Entries are inauthentic, meaning that these are not, you know, the correct books. I just put them in there. So if you click on this and it doesn't show a link, it doesn't count. If you click on this and it shows a link to full text, it counts. If you click on this and it shows a link to full text, it counts. If you click on this. So what I've tried to do, ladies and gentlemen, is to put in red links that I think links that are active to full text. So you will determine that when you get to the site of the university. But I've just, for the purpose of this demonstration, put them in red. So you click on this, nothing. You click on this, yes. So you click on this, yes. You click on this, yes. You click on this, yes. Click on this, no, 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 no. This is yes. Fine. So it's a very tough task. It's very, you know, time consuming. But that's the way it goes in terms of this thing. So how many can we count for books now? I can count 6. So there are 6 active links to full text for this whole university. Ladies and gentlemen, that is the end of step 2. Recall again, step 1 is just go to the university OER site, the one that has been configured for the ranking. Step 2 is for you to go one by one to each of the collections. Like now, we have done books. We have done books here. So that's what we got here, books. And then we're able to count like 8. So what is step number 3? Step number 3 is for us to score each collection. You know, we did books just now. Using the scoring guide, and then we enter the score in the appropriate column in the table. So the question is, where is the scoring guide? We'll take you there in a minute. It's actually in what we sent to you earlier. Yeah, so you get back to this, your instrument. You know, we're doing Abia State University now, although that's not the, we're just doing hypothetically. And we're actually looking at beta books. So you can go down to the bottom, the last page of this, which will give you the scoring scheme. That's our number 3 step. So we're not doing full text. We're doing full text, non-copyrighted books. Now the books will have to be non-copyrighted. So what do we have now? We counted how many? 5, maybe 8. So it's less than 100. So we enter 0 for that university. So we're coming up now to here for B, that's a 0. Simple, very simple. So let's go on to try some other of these collections. Maybe we'll try conference presentations. And conference presentation, you just go to all because it's an aggregation of all the conference presentations. So you can see the conference presentations here that the university, in this case now, hypothetically, Abia State University, you know, has put together. So the ones I've lettered in red are the ones that are truly linked to non-copyrighted full text full text journal. Maybe in open access. No, no, these conference presentations, I'm sorry. So this will be quite good. Most of them will not be copyrighted. So you have this, you have this, you have this, you have this. So I have actually in total here, this is number. Some may not be number, it doesn't matter. What we have here under conference presentation for all the staff in the university is 511. You see, when you get to the scoring, let's look at the scoring key here. You find that we're saying for full text conference presentations, more than 500 entries for the entire university is equal to 5. But you see, that university is not going to score any 5. For the reason that the ones that we have as, the ones that we have as linked to materials are the ones I have highlighted in red. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, just 4 out of all of this that the university has. Let's still go down to the end. So just 5, regardless of the number that they have packed down together, there are just 5 of them. So what should we score? We'll go back to our instrument. So for this, we're going to score, that's the first one, also a 0. So we go on, let's now take on another, let's take, that's the third and the last one, because the thing is the same for all the collections. Courseware, let's see journal articles, yes, let's take journal articles. These journal articles. So you can see all the journal articles here. There are very many of them. Let's go to the end. There are 416 journal articles that this university has, you know, put together. And none, as you can see, none is linked to a non-copyrighted, like open access journal and all that. You don't have any link here, just a compilation of this. So what will be the score? Before we talk about the score, let's look at journals. If you go to the bottom of this, conference presentations, we've done that. Full cover, we've done this. Lecture notes, full text, that's our D. Non-copyrighted journal articles is 0. For less than 100, that's a 0. So this also scores a 0. And then we get back to the top of the page. And that's for D, a 0. So that's how this thing goes. So you don't need to take a total, because our software at the back end, when we are doing this thing, when you are now entering this, this will get in session 2 of this training. We will do the addition, at the back end and find the mean for those who are been assigned to assess a particular university. Because this thing is time taken, we will not assign you to more than two universities. It's just like Professor Salu and NUC, assigning professors to maybe like two universities for purposes of accreditation. They finish with one and they go to it. This thing is just like accreditation. Entry scores are based on objective assessment. Yeah, so that's how step 3 looks like. So in summary, we did a 3-step process. We went to the OER site of the university. We clicked on the collections one by one and went through the links, counted the number of active links to full text, and then we scored each collection, and that's it. If you have any questions on lesson 2, please please email me, or you send me a text. Until lesson 3, where we take on scenario 2, thank you for your attention. It is bye from me, Peter the Cable Caller.